Welcome back to Let's Play Enderal, Forgotten Stories. We have the last of the black stones. Looks like everyone else is gathering here. Maybe they sense something is going to happen with the device.
Huh? Apparently we owe them for the shards of this sickle stone.
Save it.
Prophetess.
Last episode was a hard one.
Yes. Have you found any of the stones yet?
I mean any of them. You have two of them.
Yes.
How is the reconstruction of the beacon coming along?
Well, finding out about the black stones was definitely a great step forwards. But still, we're left with a myriad of questions. Sometimes I feel pathetic, to be honest. Like a child, asked to understand the functioning of a starling airship.
Yes, you were right about Kitterendal Geis. He had a son and, well...
Oh my, that is horrible. I knew Dal Geis wasn't exactly a paragon of virtue, but to abandon one's son simply because... I will never understand those sorts of people.
Me neither.
But still... This tragedy tells us we were right about our theory regarding the stones.
You think the High Ones are responsible for this? That they spoke through the stone and made Rhenaeus do what he did?
To destroy the village and make this boy suffer, that is, perfidious, truly perfidious. At least we now have all the stones. Let us complete the mosaic.
Not at that one, huh? Ah. Makes sense, yeah. Think I should stay back. Compared with other experiences, yeah.
By the left path, what power!
If we could really direct this, use it against the High Ones, whew, it might work. It just might work. Now are we... Wait a moment. You feel that?
What?
Something's different. The sea of eventualities. I can't feel it anymore.
Really? You mean you can't cast magic anymore? Could the beacon cause that?
No, I don't think so. It's like a veil put in front of my eyes. This doesn't bode well. It truly does not. Shaorim. He's currently trying to raise the barriers.
Barriers? What barriers?
The ones at the gates. They are meant to magically seal them as a protection against Korak's armies. The walls are nearly impenetrable, but the gates aren't. Shaorim said he would raise entropical barriers to take care of that. Quickly, go see him and find out what is going on. I will secure the beacon as best I can. Go!
Oh, Yuslan! I know these people mainly by their first names. We managed to load the beacon with the energy of the black stones, but the moment we put in the last stone, something weird happened. Something prevents us Arcanists from casting magic. The timing couldn't be worse. According to the Arc Magister, Yuslan Shaorim is currently trying to seal the gates to hinder the Nehrimese from raiding the city. I'm supposed to meet him immediately. Is that true, though? Seems to work, even though I couldn't actually summon my
fine shot rig.
Oh. Oh, there you are. Well, I thought we couldn't cast magic.
I tell you it won't work. I can't see anything.
But why? That just doesn't make any sense.
Well spotted. We have to inform the Grandmaster immediately.
Are they talking about the veil that's been placed? You're the gardener?
Hmm?
You're the gardener?
Knows what he's doing.
Is this the right way? Where's Yuslan?
Transcribe verse 80 100 times. Have you heard it? Apparently the Blue Islands Coalition sent an emissary here to Enderal, despite the wars. They are bold.
He's in the Noble's Quarter? Apparently.
You've got to give them that.
You're not Yuslan. You're not Yuslan. Something tells me I'm gonna need all the help I can get here.
Greetings.
Seen you, Slan?
Keep walking. Keep walking. Keep walking. An outlander. Doing in this part of the city. Shouldn't you be?
Nope, this is exactly where I'm supposed to be. Oh. Gotta find this guy.
One more time, the slow thinkers among us.
I an ovulus? My dame?
When I see
please?
One. As long as it is active, we can't put up the barrier.
I understand that you're upset, but an order is an order. I'm sorry.
What is going on?
Thank the sun, Harrenthiel. I'm trying in vain to make this highly intelligent commander of yours understand that these headaches are not arbitrary.
Grandmaster?
Sharim is right, Commander. Something is wrong. We...
What the...
Oh. The Nehrimis are inside the city! They're inside the city, dammit!
Prophetess! Mia!
What's the meaning of this?
The Nehrimis! They're inside the King's Bay! Their ships, they just appeared! I don't understand!
They just appeared? Are you trying to tell us that an entire fleet entered our harbor and nobody noticed it?
Of course. They cast an invisibility spell on their fleet. A magical blockade prevented us from recognizing them.
Nah.
Good plan. Thanks to the utterly capable military around here, and it worked out perfectly.
Watch your mouth, wild mage. Nobody...
Come on. It does not matter how it happened.
There's no time for that.
We must act quickly. Sharon, is the spell for the barrier of the gates ready?
The one at the main gate, yes. Until now, we couldn't cast it because of the blockade. Can I give the signal?
Yes. They want us to panic, but we will not do them the favor. Activate the barrier, then return to us. Soldier, you said that the Nehrimis have already invaded the city. To what extent?
There. In the fog district, I think. They overran the harbor gate before we were able to close it.
The fog?
Sergeant Harlechan has entrenched himself at the gate of the lower district. He won't be able to hold it for long.
Good. Come on. Station your soldiers on the battlement and use arrows to keep the Nehrimis at a distance. Don't let them get close to the market. You, Prophetess, will accompany me there. We will liberate the south quarter and then secure the harbor gate, so that Sharim will be able to place a barrier there as well. At least the heart of the city will be safe then.
We're going to fight.
Where's the fog
yes.
district?
Now go. Time is of the essence.
Understood. Soldier, follow me.
Are you ready?
You guys have a fog district? I've been all over this city. But the Nehrimis are in the city. How in blazes have they managed to enter without anybody noticing them? Well, he said they turned the fleet invisible.
Magic, as Sharon said. They've put a spell on their fleet to make it invisible.
I knew that.
Probably the doing of Korek's mute bodyguard. I've heard stories about
him. Oh, yeah.
And I fear they have infiltrated us in secret, too.
Mr. Pinch.
But we won't discuss this now. Are you ready?
I hope so.
Good. We need to find Sergeant Harlia. The soldier said he's in the south quarter. Follow me. Bastards. They won't pay for it.
There you are. I'm right here. Into the south quarter we go. Pennies are indispensable for the development of your character. Yeah, die already. Right there. They don't have anything good on them, do they? It's the chef.
Bloody care what you're thinking. Secure the damn gate!
Sergeant Harlian.
Who?
Grandmaster Aranthiel. It is an honor.
The honor is mine. What is the gate's status?
Bad. Dozens of Nehrimis are behind this gate, and they're setting up rams.
Then we will stop them. We have to secure the harbor gate. Costs. Once we have done that, our mages will seal the gate. This is all of you, I take it?
For now, yes. But reinforcements are on the way. I forgive my failure, Master. We should have seen it coming, but everything just happened so quickly.
The Myrid's in flight.
I know. Now come on. We march out. Every second we wait will help the enemy.
Yes, sir.
Minstrel.
God, the Grandmaster is relying on us, and so is Malthus.
Calm down, Minstrel.
Live up to your names.
Yes, sir!
Go!
Rid the harbor of the Nehrimis. No one came with us. Didn't mean to do that.
Aaron's archers, just at the right time.
Oh, the humanity.
What the?
Oh, jeez. Aye.
Good. Now, close the gate.
Yes.
Oh, he doesn't have anything good.
It's jammed, Sergeant!
What? What are you talking about?
Is it possible that the Nehrimis have sabotaged the mechanism?
Yes, of course, there must be. What can...
The locking mechanisms of the gate are on both sides of the wall, correct?
Yes. Yes, Master, that's right.
Good. Prophet, you and I will fix the cracks. Sergeant, in the meantime, you and your men will keep the Nehrimis off the gate. When we are finished, we will give the signal for retreat. Understood?
We fix the cracks.
Yes, Master, of course.
Get it. Omar, prepare the cannon. Let's show the bastards what it means to defy the Lightborn.
We will await your signal, Grandmaster. May his light guide you.
And you. Follow me, Prophetess, to the beacon.
Oh, I thought I was supposed to fix that crank. Oh, we're gonna go through there.
Well then, there are two cranks with which the portcullis is controlled. One. I'm sure they're trying their best to do just that. It will take time. The defense mechanisms of Ark are more than solid. Let's not push our luck, however. Go.
Hurry up, damn it!
I am hurrying.
Waste of time.
Waste of time, huh? Where am I supposed to go? Up here? Oh!
Retreat! Now!
The hell? Another vision?
For freedom!
Owie? I'll feed on the stable boy, why not? What are you doing? What are you doing with those sausages? Repair the left gate crank. Ark is under attack! Somehow the Nehrimese managed to get their ships past the outposts unnoticed. Now they are raiding the city. According to Aranthiel, our only chance is to reconquer the entrance to the harbor as fast as possible and to seal the gate magically. By doing so, we can stop the advance of Korak's armies into the city. So I guess we are going this way. Ever been in here? There's like chests and stuff with coins in them.
There they are! Gid! Nara! Prepare the fire spitter!
Thou art my light, my shimmer at the horizon, your...
Fire!
Is that them, or is that my... vision?
Wait a second...
No waiting a second! Good job! Short work of these guys. He was kind of tough. Have to be close enough. Some fun, huh? Look at that old mask. That looks familiar. Sorry about that. Alright, I fixed the crank. Ensure Patrolman Harlogen's retreat. Am I just returning to... What's his name? Tilar now? Attacked by more people? Need a key for that. footprint. Hi.
It is working.
You heard it. Retreat.
What? Retreat now.
Oh, it's Pinchy.
Something, Grandmaster.
Pinchy. I can't attack Pinchy. Ah. Whoa. Damn you, Pinchy! Ugh. Ow! That actually hurt a little bit. You slap.
Well, I suppose reconquering the gate didn't go as well as planned, did it? What happened here?
Secure the gate.
Oh. I didn't need that. Sorry.
However, seems we have a visitor.
Yep.
Timur Aranthiel on the battlefield. I must confess, I am surprised. Oh my, look at these poor fools. Trusted you until the end. Seems you still value human life as little as you did back in Kira. How many people was it, Aranthiel? I have forgotten.
Wise words from the mouth of a warmonger.
Oh, so that is what I am to you. If I remember correctly, it was you who refused to negotiate. You might not believe it, but I enjoy this no more than you do.
Sure you don't.
Hence, one more time, Aranthiel, surrender. Your so-called army is a joke compared to mine, and it is merely a matter of time until we find a way into the city. So, once in your life, make the right call and end this conflict before it gets even bloodier than it is now.
Well said, Quark. So, you expect us to do more? Asking your wisdom, kneel before you?
Yaslan Sharim, how disappointing to see you here. All your life you have fought religion and its tentacles, and now you fight for it.
I fight for something called common sense. Should try it sometime.
Yeah.
As I said, Aranthiel, last chance. Stop working on the beacon and no one will be harmed. The cleansing has to happen and you will not stop it.
We don't want to all die.
I will. No, is that all? It is. Oh, it is. Alma, line up the prisoners. I want to see each one of them crucified before nightfall. And then inform the troops. Every Enderalian will be killed on sight.
Understood.
Enderalian.
What? Religion is a sickness, Aranthiel. And it is the cause of pretty much all the evil that has happened in this world over the past millennia. Your son saw that too, unlike you. But he also made a fatal mistake.
He didn't kill you?
To believe that the death of the Lightborn was going to change things. But they were just a symptom, not the cause of the sickness. The cause is religiosity itself, this particular way of thinking.
Religiosity? I think the cause of this sickness is madmen like you.
Oh, believe me, my train of thought is more rational than you might think.
Don't think so.
Religious people choose irrationality above reason, and dogmas above free thinking. They turn themselves into puppets, and by doing this, they are responsible too. And your behavior, Aranthiel, is the last proof I needed. Believe me, I wish there were another way, but you have shown me that there isn't. The High Ones will never elevate us until the ulcer of religiosity has been torn from every single head in this world. I've tried the peaceful way, but you don't seem to want it. Now live with the consequences.
They're not gonna...
By the way, it's good to see that you have survived. What's about to happen now is your fault, Aranthiel. Don't even try to convince yourself otherwise.
They're not gonna elevate us, you madman. They want to cleanse us. Cleanse, as in...
We need to go back to the temple.
Why didn't you help Harlan and the guardsmen?
And lead that entropist right into the city? Their death was necessary. It was an honor for them.
That's a really stupid thing to say. So what do we do now?
We will proceed as planned. Light the beacon as soon as possible. That is all that matters.
Yeah. So he's gonna...
How long do you need to seal the gate?
It was an hour.
Good. Be quick about it. Guardsman, what is the situation in the other districts? Are all of the intruders dead?
Yes, Grand Master. Some of the infiltrators have fled into the sewers, but we're in pursuit.
Good. Tell the commander that I want all corpses to be disposed of before nightfall, and let the repairs start as soon as possible. We are protected from intruders, but we have to be aware of a panicking crowd inside. Then tell her to place archers and fire breathers on every battlement. Their arcanists will try to break the seals.
So wait.
We won't let them.
Understood, Grand Master.
You're a Nehrim's mage.
Now then, let us go.
Yeah, she's busy. She's dead. Sorry, she's Nehrim's. Alright, so I gotta teleport back to the... to Ark. Is there a street sign around here? What do I have? Do I have a teleport? I might. For all I know, he gave me one and I just didn't notice. Oh, sharp pain flakes through your... Teleport to Ark! Duh. What's wrong with me? That's the one I want.
The righteous path, you are well.
What happened to Jorik? And why in blazes do you stand around like bloody waxwork figures?
We succeeded. Despite the many casualties, Aranthiel, a troop of guardsmen and I managed to seal the harbor gate. There was another confrontation with Taranor Korak, and he tried once more to convince us to stop building the beacon and to let the cleansing happen. Aranthiel refused, whereupon Korak announced a radical change of course. He wants to make an example of his prisoners till this evening, and from now on kill every sighted Enderalian. I mean, he's trying to do that to stop us from lighting the beacon and stopping the cleansing from happening? But it's not really going to work. It's not really going to work because the cleansing would kill everybody. Not just Enderalians and not just his prisoners.
Jorik has betrayed us, Tilor.
What?
Jorik?
He has revealed the locations of our scouting posts to Korak's army. That's why we didn't see their ships coming. A keeper has caught him talking to Korak through one of the silver plates.
Ah.
And don't worry, he's only unconscious.
It was him!
Commander. Get him out of here.
Of course, Grandmaster.
Traitor.
Where should I take him?
Anywhere, for heck's sake!
We will deal with him later. This is not a case for the tribunal.
Very well, Grandmaster.
What is the status of the beacon? Where is Marigel?
At the beacon. And there is a problem with your machine. But that's something they should tell you themselves. Now, excuse me, the entire city is in panic. The people expect an explanation.
Then give them one. Follow the prophetess to the beacon.
I don't care, dammit. Just do it.
Alright, so what kind of problem do we have with the machine?
I tell you, there's no word about Numenos.
Numenos?
Well, if you say so, then I guess we have to get used to the idea that our machine will not glow anytime soon.
Who's this?
What are you talking about?
We have seen her before.
Right. Yes, that is right. We have the stones, and they give the beacon the energy it needs, as we had assumed. But
this crystal in the middle of the cross is the core of the machine, the Numenos.
So?
The Numenos is empty, Grandmaster. That's why it is so dark. If we were to ignite the beacon now, its energy would be emitted aimlessly, with devastating results.
An explosion, to be precise. An enormous one.
And that's something we hadn't noticed before?
Unfortunately, we don't have a lot of experience in building Pyrian machines. Mm. So, yes, indeed, we had not noticed it before.
So this means we've been working with a huge powder keg all this time.
No, it's more than that. The beacon can defeat the High Ones. The more we learn about it, the more certain we become. However, it needs a target, a kind of focal point. And if we ignite it without one, things will become very uncomfortable.
Something tells me the way you say uncomfortable, you're understating it a little bit. So the beacon explodes if we ignite it with an empty Numenos? And I guess I have to go into some dark dungeon to get one, don't I?
Yes. At least that's what the writing suggests. Imagine the beacon as a huge arcane barrel full of black powder. To ignite it means to release all the energy stored within. And for all we know, it will be streaming towards the container with the crystal in its center, the Numenos. However, if this Numenos is empty, then it will backfire, so to speak. An explosion.
Well, it's a good thing you guys realized that before you actually activated it. However you would activate it in the first place. So, without the Numenos, the beacon is useless.
So it seems, yes.
I am very sorry, Grandmaster. We should have seen it coming.
As soon as possible.
Yes. And before you ask, we don't know yet what the Numenos actually is, and neither do we know where to search for it.
But we will find a way. Give us a week, maybe two, and there will be results, I assure you.
I don't think we have that time.
Let's rest. We'll need it.
Oh my. Such chaos.
Yeah, Sigil Master Bartar. Chuchessa said he betrayed us?
Yes, he did. Even though he was one of the closest confidants of the Grand Master, I don't know what to say.
That part isn't good. A close confidant. Do we at least know why he did it?
Not really. But it was no secret that he regarded the Grand Master's actions against the Nehrimese as careless. He does not seem to understand that the beacon is our only chance.
He was arguing with him about that stuff. Can I somehow help you in finding this Numenos?
Yes, I think so. But right now, we can't do anything but read the writings from old Dothu Gran for the upteenth time, hoping for some clue we might have missed before.
I don't think we're gonna have weeks. Or a week. So all we can do now is search for the Numenos and hope that the Nehrimese won't find a way into the city before then.
Yes, I guess. You should take a rest. I was told what you did to secure the gate. We'll call you as soon as we need your help. Yes? Well, you heard the Grand Master. It is ready to be let. All that's left to do is find that Numenos in order to have something we can use the stone's energy on.
A little stairs trick again.
A machine can banish these High Ones. Mysteries of this world are endless, aren't they?